Thank you all participants and our respected principal for being with us in this inaugural function. Today we are having three sessions and our first session is steered by Shahjahan sir. Shahjahan sir is currently working as managing director in Kerala Automobiles Limited. He had done his BTech and MBA from PKM College of Engineering affiliated to Kerala University. He also had gained numerous certifications such as Fellow in Valuates, Fellow in Technical Arbitrates, and Chartered Engineer. Due to his urge for continuous learning and enthusiasm for electric vehicles, he is currently doing his PhD in e-mobility. He started his career in the IT sector, and after proving his excellence there, he served as the Managing Director of Handloom Development Corporation of Kerala, Managing Director of Kerala Artisans Development Corporation, Managing Director of Kerala Ceramics Limited, and at present Managing Director of Kerala Automobiles Limited since 2018. Now we are over to Shahjahan sir for a wonderful knowledge transfer session. I welcome you, sir. Sir, can you please unmute your mic? You are not audible for us, sir.
Can you see the presentation?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes. Now we can see it very clearly. Yes, sir. Now we can see it very clearly, sir.
Okay. This is today's our topic is EV charging challenges in charging and impact on power grid. So you all know that there's a tremendous challenge for the implementation of the e-mobility. The one major challenge will be the range concern of e-vehicle. That is the how a range of an e-vehicle can be addressed by these companies or users or who are using this vehicle. The thing will be that is only the point coming will be the charging infrastructures, and the second point will be the battery technologies. So battery technology is one of the major technology, major innovations coming in the future days, or till now that innovations are going. The thing is, we know that all our IC engine vehicle having acid batteries, we are using the electrode and an electrolyte as acid, dilute sulfuric acid. Here, in electric vehicle, normally we are using only lithium ion batteries. There are different chemistries for the lithium ion batteries because the lithium ion batteries having more SOC than any other batteries. So lithium ion battery having the different chemistries like lithium ferrophosphate, NMCs, and lithium titanate, the other chemistries also coming out with the lithium ion batteries. And the another batteries nowadays having a very good presence will be the lithium titanate battery, which have its own advantages for charging, discharging, and the life cycle. Then aluminum oxide battery and some other batteries are coming out for this lithium base. As far as lithium ion battery is concerned, there's a huge time required for the charging a battery in the normal condition. So every battery is manufactured by the different combinations of the cells, that is lithium cells. So for lithium cells having different capacities, that is what is called a C rating of lithium cells. Normally 0.5 C rating up to 2Z rating and 4Z ratings are available. The C rating means the Coulomb rating, which means that there is the battery can be charged in a particular rate and the discharge can be also having a some different rating. A 0.5 rating C rating battery took minimum of 4 to 5 hours to fully recharge, and its discharging rate also may be 0.5 or 1 C rating. So the current delivered by this battery is in the form of a 0.5 C rating or 1 C rating, and charging also in the rate of 0.5 rating to 1 C rating. And at the same time, the battery having different discharge C rating and a different charging C rating. Depending upon the charging C rating, the battery charge can be or the charging time can be reduced. So if it is a 3C or 4C charge rating, the charging can be drastically reduced by 30 minutes or 1 hour, like that. But in the normal time, the charging time will be much more. Simply, if you have a mobile phone, right now we are available with fast charging chargers and slow charging chargers. That is quite normally it is 1 ampere charger and a 2 ampere charger. Once it is 1 ampere charger, then our mobile phone will be charging will take a hell of a lot of time. But if it is a 2 ampere charger, it can charge much faster, right? So within half an hour, the battery can be this can be charging in a much faster way. So what happened is much much faster way. In this case, once it is fast charging in your mobile, what happens is the mobile will be overheated. You feel straight away you feel the overheating. Similarly, in a battery situation also, if it is go for a fast charging, the battery is also overheated. So we will go for a cooling technologies, cooling system for the batteries, because in your battery it is 2400 mAh, but in electric vehicle batteries, it will be minimum 100 Ah and it comes around 250 Ah, 300 Ah, like that. So the heat generated by each cell will be much more or very huge as compared to your mobile batteries. So it requires the cooling systems. For lithium batteries, the different type of cooling systems we are using. One is the air cooling system and the liquid cooling system. Normally, the buses using the liquid cooling system, and air cooling system is also one of the method we are using. At the same time, the another type of battery is available will be lithium titanate battery. So lithium ion battery having the life cycle of 1500 life cycle only up to 2000 life cycle. For a lithium titanate battery whose life cycle will be 25,000 life cycle. One life cycle will be one fully charging and fully discharging will take it as a one life cycle. So what happened is lithium titanate battery whose Z rating will be much more, whose charging time will be very less. So within that period of 8 minutes, we can charge 80% of the other battery, and within 20 minutes, we can charge the full charging. So the charging concern can be, charging difficulty can be eliminated by the introduction of this lithium titanate battery. But the major problem for lithium titanate battery will be the cost will be 2 to 3 times higher than the lithium battery. So vehicle cost will be much higher. Once the number of e-vehicle will be coming in the picture or in the roads, automatically the battery cost will be reducing. Thereby, we will get a much better price for this titanate battery also. So then what are the charging methods we are using for the E-vehicles, yeah. When will be every charging, this is the policy which was framed by the government for the charging infrastructures. Everybody is seeing this slide, yeah? Hello?
Yes, sir, hello. Yes. Now the slide has okay. changed. Before it was not changing.
Okay, it's okay. That is the preface of the presentation. This will be the clear picture regarding the charging modes and everything. The government having some rules regarding the charging. So every charging station have a minimum 3 fast charging and 2 slow charging facilities. Then only government will give the approval for the charging stations. Because internationally there are some accepted standards are there. One will be CSS, combined charging system style plug. Second will be CHAdeMO. And the third will be AC fast chargers. Then 2 slow charging mode points. One in Bharat DC-001 and Bharat AC-001. These are the 5 charging protocol used by the government or announced by the government to be used by these every charging stations. So generally the different manufacturers having different charging systems. So some manufacturers providing CCS, some will be CHAdeMO, some will be type 2 AC fast chargers to slow charging for the DC and AC. Then CSS and CHAdeMO having minimum output of 50 kilowatt to 200 kilowatt with 1000 watts, 200 to 1000 watts. The type 2 plug-in having a minimum 22 kilowatt and whose voltage will be 280 to 480 volt. Bharat 001 connection with a 15 kilowatt and which is coming from 72 to 220. This DC charging is used by normally cars then and auto rickshaws like that. The Bharat 001 will be 10 kilowatt and whose will be a single phase 230 volt is enough for Bharat AC-001. As is one electric vehicle charging station in a grid with 300 meters or within 3 kilometers. This is a policy of the government because every 3 kilometers there must be one charging station. That means our petrol bank will be converted into or the petrol bank will have a minimum one electric charging stations. So the charging station concentration will go on increasing. On highway, there will be a charging station in every 25 kilometers. That means in a radius of 2-3 kilometers must have in every one charging station. And in the highway, every 25 kilometers having one charging station. Private charging station will be permitted at a residence. And the distribution companies, DISCOMs are facilitated in the same. So in your residence also having a one charging stations. So the regulatory authority will give the permission and you can earn the money. Setting up a public charging station will be a de-licensed activity and any individual can free to set up a public charging station as per the norms. So not just like a petrol pump, everybody can set up a charging station as per the norms. It is quite easy to set up the charging station. Once this charging station is increasing or number of charging stations increases, automatically e-mobility will go on increasing. This is just a slide for this one. CSS having minimum 50 kilowatt. The voltage rating will be 2200 to 1000 watt. And the number of charging point will be number of connectors. The gun means number of charging guns will be 1/1. And in the CHAdeMO, it is 200 to 1000. And this is also the charging gun will be the same. Type 2 will be 380. I already explained these cases, just only table only. Then another type of charging infrastructure coming in future will be wireless e-vehicle charging system, that is WEVCS. Based on the application wireless charging system, there are 2 type of wireless charging system. You all are knows that you all are professionals, you are all the teachers. You know the static wireless charging and the dynamic wireless charging. So, based on the operating technologies, capacity wireless charging systems are available, permanent magnet, gear wireless charging system is available, induction wireless charging system is available, resonant inductive wireless charging systems are available. What are the challenges faced by these charging systems, that is, wireless charging system? To install the static, dynamic wireless charging station on the roads, normally what will happen, a dedicated infrastructure is required. That is a dedicated static dynamic wireless charging infrastructure. Roads are required for installation of this one, this wireless charging system, which requires a hell of a lot of money. The huge money is required. Need to maintain EMC, EMI frequencies. That EMI, EMC is electromagnetic induction coefficient. So this is the major EMI and EMC is the major pollutions emitted from any e-vehicle and electrical and electronic equipment. That is EMI and EMC. So this will affect all the electronics equipment. So there is a clear standard of controlling this EMI and EMC is required for wireless electric charging stations. For electric vehicle also, this EMI EMC is a major test happened in ARI or any testing facility. Then what are the challenges for e-mobilities or EV implementation or e-charging implementation or total EVs? The cost of EV in India bumps up primarily due to the lithium batteries, because the cost of lithium battery is much higher than any other batteries. So previously per kilowatt lithium battery having a cost of $1,000, now it is reduces to $200. So definitely in future it will reduce. Then battery pack, which are important, the cost will be, right now it is $275 per kilowatt, it also reduces to up to $200. The availability of lithium, short supply of lithium in India, but China having huge deposit of lithium. That is why China is somewhat better positioned in the manufacturing of batteries and motors in China. Currently, the annual electric vehicle sale will be only 0.1% of total 3 million cars per annum. That is, you just feel the gap of EV sales or EV car sales. The predicted that the inflection point of these batteries is about 1,000 to 500, 1,100 to 150 dollars per kilowatt. We are predicted up to in 2020-25. That means in 2025, the cost of vehicle will be reduced up to 30 to 40%. That is 50% of the cost of the vehicle is from the battery cost only. So charging time record will be 3 to 8 hours. So it is a major constraint, major hurdles for any vehicle owners. It is, we wait for a 3 to 8 hours for the charging, it is much difficult. Fast charging can go well to up to 90 minutes. Less than 20 minutes is the comfortable charging time. So fast charging facility is available up to 90 minutes. But for the introduction of lithium titanate battery, it can be reduced up to 20 minutes for the full charging and 6 to 8 minutes for the 80%. DC charging point and need charging infrastructure, which is yet another difficult obstacle to overcome. That is, DC charging infrastructure requires more security features and other things. So it requires the more infrastructures. Normally, a visit to petrol station can add up to 500 kilometer range, and it is hardly take 10 minutes. So that to achieve, the EV needs charging for the long period. So if we get within 10 minutes in a charging station or charging facilities, the people will be so happy and they will accept it. And also minimum, the long distance traveling people request minimum 500 kilometers range for the single filling. So this another will be shortage of charging stations. So in India there are about 222 charging stations with 353 charging points for about more than 1 lakh or approximately 2 lakhs electric vehicle. So there is a shortage of charging stations. But if you look at the petrol pumps, around 56,000 petrol pumps are there in the country, which is much more as compared to the charging stations. The energy for providing the traction motor should have a considerable amount of share in the renewable energy. India is a major electricity, majorly electricity is produced by burning out the coal. So in our precedent points, how it will be affected the national grid. Yeah. So what happens, the more electricity is used for the charging infrastructures, we produce the more current. If we think about the Kerala, we are producing the electricity by hydroelectric projects and renewable energy sources. But the rest of the countries, most of them using the coal as one of the major raw material for producing the electricity. What is the ultimate result for the outcome for the waste energy eliminated from the coal will be the carbon dioxide. So the
sir, your mic is in muted position, sir. Please unmute it, sir. Shajan, sir. Shajan, sir, your mic is in muted position.
Okay.
And the participants are saying that the slides are not changing, sir. Please.
Now it is okay.
We are getting the presentation only, sir. It's coming. Yeah, now we got the presentation, sir. Yes, sir. Now it's okay, sir. Sir, still you are not audible, sir. Your mic is in mute position, sir. Kindly unmute your mic.
It's automatically unmuted. Yeah. No. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes. Now it's okay. Sir, again it has gone into mute position, sir. Sir, please unmute it or please try to do the presentation.
Maybe this was happened from this administrator level. Your administrator can accidentally mute my mic. Yeah, I am not doing anything for muting the mic.
Okay, sir. Okay. Now you are audible for us. Sir. Once when the presentation is getting started, it's getting muted.
Now it is okay?
Now it is okay, sir. Now it is okay.
Okay. So, the coal will have 1 kilogram and wind energy is only 10 grams of carbon dioxide and 50 grams of carbon dioxide can be produced from the solar energies. Okay, so this is the solution. What are the solution for this constraints? To track is impossible without the government support, the Make in India innovation policies. So for more infrastructures, automotive sector has to sacrifice some profit for the future gain at start. So we will provide some subsidies or the profit will be reduced. A considerable amount of R&D is at most the importance so that the cost can be brought down as much as possible. Development of renewable energy source should be a run of parallel to EVs. So these are the major thing about this infrastructures. So solutions and constraints or difficulties for putting up EV infrastructures. Then the second part in that our presentation will be, so how it will be affect the national grid. Yeah. So normally what happens if 30% of the vehicle will be converted into e-mobility, only 5% of change in the electric usage will be coming in picture only. So there is no hell a lot of problems will be affected in the national grid. And at the same time, nowadays, all the electrical substations or generating stations are linked to a single point, so that is national grid, that is smart grid technologies. So if Kerala having some difficulty in getting Electricity, it can be automatically fed from the some other state like northern state or northeastern state. They have a tremendous supply of electricity. So as far as the electricity case is concerned, there is no problem for getting electricity or electric power for charging infrastructures. At the same time, we can have some ecosystem for developing for charging infrastructures, because we can charge the vehicle in the off-peak period, normal peak period and off-peak period. In the from night 10 to morning 6 o'clock will be the off-peak period. For that particular period, we can use the charging and other things. So our grid will be not overloaded. So we can manage the grid with a smart grid system. We can easily manage the grid system. This is the small presentation regarding these e-mobilities and its charging systems and the charging facilities. If anybody having any doubt and any doubt regarding this charging infrastructures, battery charging and development of e-mobilities or electric vehicle, I will just share how to go ahead with that one, and I will just clear the small doubts regarding that one. If you, at the same day, if you have any doubt in future, you can call my mobile number, which is in the lower side of this this presentation, 9846017034. Actually, we are developing this vehicle indigenously in our factory itself with our team of members. And this is the picture with the sum of our team members, workers, and our chairman, Mr. Karaman Hari. Everybody knows he's a good politician and a tremendous politician in the southern area. Not only in southern, all over Kerala, he knows well. He's coming from his college days onwards, from the student politics onwards, he's coming in the picture. So he's the best supporter for me for developing this vehicle. Okay, thank you. Thank you all for listening my presentation. And if you have any doubt, you please ask. Just I will share my thought and views regarding these e-mobilities here. Thank you all.
Good morning, sir. This is Gaurav Kadge. Shall I ask the question?
Okay, sure.
Yeah, thank you. Sir, thank you very much for this wonderful information. I just have a query. Like, we are listening to electrical vehicles from last 2 years, or rather 5 years, but still, India is not getting that much of response in the vehicles, electric vehicles. In fact, the buyers are not much interested in buying the electrical vehicles, maybe two wheelers or four wheelers. So can you just throw some light on it?
It's a very good question, Mr. J.S. Gardner.
Yes.
The thing will be, it's a new technology. People will have some hesitation to adopt that technologies, because thing will be, if we look into the electric car, a lowest cost of any electric car will be costing around 15 lakhs rupees. So people must have some hesitation for investing this 15 lakhs rupees for the new technology. Then also they are afraid about what will be the tomorrow's technologies regarding the e-mobility. One thing, this is for the illiterate people. This is the concern for the illiterate people. Once it is have a technology person or some literacy persons, they think that tomorrow we will get a better e-vehicle, because better battery technology, better motor technology, like that. So they will wait for the better technology. The third major constraint will be charging infrastructures. So people will think that where I will go for charge this vehicle. And for that one, we will give some education to these people, or some training, or some demonstration, or any means we will educate these people. What is the advantages of e-mobility? How we can charge the vehicle? So basically this e-mobility will initiate from three-wheeler, then two-wheelers, then buses, then cars, then go ahead. the thing will be the normal public utility vehicle or public transport vehicle in the lower category will be auto rickshaws, whose cost will be approximately 3 lakh rupees only. People will ready to invest 3 lakh rupees for the auto rickshaws. The second point is every auto rickshaw is coming with a onboard charger, so there is no dependency on public charging station. For auto rickshaws, as far as 100 kilometers or 90 kilometers riding a single auto rickshaw for a single charging, it requires only 6 kilowatt power only, 6 unit power only. For 6 unit power, for the normal current rating, it will be 35 rupees. For 35 rupees means per kilometer running cost will be 35 paise only. So at the maximum, we put it as a 50 paise. As far as a diesel vehicle, as far as current scenario, it will be 3 rupees. For by comparing these two cases, we educate them that within 2 years, the return of investment will be in their pocket. So people, once they realize this one, people will accept three wheelers. Am I correct? The second point,
yes,
will
sir,
be,
correct.
Second point will be then e-scooters. Normally what happened, we will educate employed youth or employees or government employees or whatever employees, they can use the vehicle for a 15-20 kilometers in one side. So daily their usage will be around 50 to 70 kilometers. Right now with the 60 to 70,000 rupees, these scooters are available with 70 kilometers range. So they start using e-scooters. So e-mobility start from e-autos and e-scooters. Then the public charging, public the common utility vehicle as the e-buses. So once we go for e-buses, once the e-buses is into the market, normally charging infrastructures will be developing throughout the state, throughout the country. So people will start buying this vehicle. This is a major constraint for sales of e-vehicle and promotion of e-mobility. For that point, our technology people can have a very good role. We will have some classes to the auto drivers, auto unions for this process. And I put up some comparative statement for electric auto and diesel autos. So the thing will be, within 2 years, the return of investment for electric auto will be in our pocket. Am I clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
At the same time, you will get a future mobility for hydrogen fuel mobility. So everybody is looking for the future mobility. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Can I ask one more question?
Sure. No problem.
Yeah. Sir, instead of having a basic electric vehicle, if we have a hybrid electric vehicle, don't you think it is useful and people will prefer more?
Well, the thing will be, what is hybrid electric vehicle? Hybrid is also one of the option, because we can eliminate the fear from the people. Because it will be laying nearby any road for eroding the charges for the batteries and other things. That is one of the option, no sure. But once this charging infrastructure goes on increasing, that concern also eliminated, one thing. So in the hybrid electric vehicle, in some point of view, it is an option. But for a hybrid system, it also eliminates the carbon dioxide. Carbon emission is more, but it will be less. It must be less than pure IC engine vehicle. So my point will be, the initial stage itself, we go with a electric vehicle. And right now, all the manufacturers are thinking about the dual battery systems. Yeah, I'm also going for the dual battery system, because people having some concern that one battery is totally discharged or some BMS having some problem, it will be stopped in between the riding, what to do? So if the dual battery system, we can use the second battery to cover the mileage. So the major bottleneck can be avoided, but the cost will be much more.
Okay, thank you, sir. Sir, last question.
Okay.
Is it possible to have the hybrid like solar plus wind electric vehicles? Because like there are no much work is done.
Okay, that is absolutely a right question. But for that question, the best guess to answer that question will be you people, because you are the technology people. You have the young brain in your hands. You have the total studies regarding or R&D and doctorate regarding these so many topics. So you provide this point to your young energetic blood, that is your students, and they will develop the better option for this solution. Okay. Anyway, I will give a small solution and a small reply regarding that one. The thing will be, as far as the solar energy is concerned, right now the best solar panel available in the world having a efficiency of 200 to 300 watt power per square meter of solar panel. So what happened? Am I correct? Yeah.
Yes,
it absolutely okay. So if you are getting 300 watt power in a per square meter, we are using 6 kilowatt battery. So how much area is required for charging this battery, or how much time required for charging this battery with a small rooftop area of an auto rickshaw? The maximum rooftop area of auto rickshaw is only the 2 square meter maximum 2 square meter. So from there we are getting only 600 to 700 watt of power per hours. So power we are getting only this much watts power means is very difficult to charge this system. Okay. The second will be the wind energy. So if we can do some development or some R&D regarding the small wind fan will be using in the top of the this auto rickshaws or any vehicle. The exhaust fan can be generating small air. This will be fed to the second fan. It can generate more RPM. Like that, maybe we can produce some powers. That how much extent? I don't know exactly how much extent. But solar, I just do some studies regarding the solar. So that is another one option. I can put up another option for you people. The vehicle is running with that some air resistance, or it is pulling push and pull technologies. You just the push pull train. So if you just think about that, if you can fix a naturally running fan in the vehicle in somewhere else, is it displaces the air in the reverse direction, just like a boat or other things. So it can move much faster than what normally running. I don't know exactly. I just my idea from my mind only. So it can I increase the mileage of the vehicle? If for a single charging it can run up to 90 kilometer, means by putting this additional naturally driven systems, it can increase the mileage by the 10% or 10%. The people will be happy. Like that also you can think about. These are the college level R&D to be developed.
Yes, okay. Sir, thank you, sir. Thank
you. You are from which state?
Sir, I am from Maharashtra. Nagpur.
Oh, you are from Nagpur. Yeah. Huh, okay.
Yeah, I am working with Paluti Engineering College.
Okay. Okay.
It's NBA NAC and Autonomous Institution.
Oh, very good.
Yeah.
Because Maharashtra having very good presence in e-bike, because. In future it must have some good presence, but right now Maharashtra is not up to that level. I got so many inquiries from Maharashtra regarding the dealership and the distributorship in Maharashtra.
Okay, right now presently three wheelers are doing well in e-vehicles, and Nitinji Gadkariji is doing in that he is promoting e-vehicles in all the aspects.
There is some misconception in e-3-wheelers. Yeah, there are two types of three-wheelers are available. One will be e-auto and the second will be e-rickshaw.
Okay.
Everybody is thinking about these. Both are the e-autos. Yeah, but it's totally different. E-rickshaw having normally in Delhi and other state, there are tremendous numbers of e-rickshaws is available. But e-auto manufacturer in India is only 3 or 4 players only. The major difference between e-autos and e-rickshaw is e-rickshaw having only a 1000 kilowatt motor they are using. Their power will be very minimum. Their maximum speed will be only 25 kilometers. Their testing procedures will be very, very, very minimum. There is no rigid testing procedure is there. But as far as e-auto is concerned, whose power will be more than 2 kilowatt. So it can handle any terrain, any gradient. Power will be more. The kilometer speed will be 45 to 50 kilometer more. So it can carry out all the test, all the security features and a test conducted by this ARI. But the e-rickshaw having only 30% of the test as compared to e-autos. So cost will be also different. This is the two difference between e-autos and e-rickshaws. People will compare both the same.
Yes, thank you so much for this.
Then anybody else?
Nagaraju sir has asked a doubt, sir.
Okay,
Nagaraju sir, he has asked in the chat room, which charging station are better, sir, AC or DC? That is his doubt. Which charging stations are better, AC or DC?
If you compare our requirement, if you request a fast charging, definitely go for the DC charging. DC fast charging. If you want the slow charging, go for a AC charging station. But the thing will be, as far as AC charging station, infrastructure is very minimum. Very minimum infrastructure only. The KSEB will fed you the power. If it is a 3 kilowatt charging station, you can have only single phase system with a maximum 20 ampere current. 16 to 20 ampere current is required. For another, the fast AC charging, the three-phase supply with a three-phase current rating is only. But the DC charging system, what happened? This AC can be converted to the DC. So a DC circuit is required. And this DC having, it's around 72 to more than 200 volt system. So security is much more, safety is much more. So 72 volt DC is more dangerous than 72 volt AC, you know well. So security system, safety features are more in DC. So both having its own use. For two wheelers and three wheelers, normally using the AC charging. For buses, cars, somebody using AC and DC, buses normally using the DC charging systems. So that is why government announces that every charging station must have these 5 charging protocols. TSS, CHAdeMO and AC, DC and charging, Bharat AC, DC charging protocols. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Good morning.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes.
Actually, for gas cylinder, if we take, we have the specified dimension and pressure and weight. Like that, if we go with the electric batteries, then the charging station and all will become more efficient and portability become much easier. Why government is not moving in this way?
That means your doubt will be why government is not moving into the e-mobility or electric charging station. Am I correct?
Yes, sir. With the specification, like IEEE standard something, they can make a own standard telling that battery size should be this much only, and the capacity, everything, if they come out with one standard, then it will be much easier, because now that electric vehicle batteries are not portable. So that for battery swapping, it will be much easier.
Mr. Dr. Shivaprasad, the thing will be, the size of the battery is depending upon the power of the battery, because if you go with a 30 Ah battery, 30 kilowatt or 0.3 kilowatt or 0.5 kilowatt or 1 kilowatt battery, the weight of the battery will be less than 10 kg or less than 5 kg, less than 5 kg or 10 kg. But if you go with a 6 kilowatt battery, the battery weight will be 50 kg plus. So it is very difficult to handle the 50 kg by a single person. Then for that cases, we go for the swappable battery system. The small swappable battery system for the mini vehicle, just like auto rickshaws and like that. So we, if it is a 6 kilowatt battery, we go with a 2 kilowatt, three numbers, which will be cascaded or synchronized together to form a full battery system. That is also possible, some vehicle coming with this swappable battery system. For onboard battery system and swappable battery systems are the two different things. For an onboard battery system, we are not able to replace the battery, we can charge the battery with the vehicle itself. So that cost will be, that weight will be 50 plus or more. For a swappable battery system, we can swipe the battery by using a swappable modules, just like a 2 kilowatt module like that. For an auto rickshaw, the 2 kilowatt, 3 number of battery is enough for 100 kilometers ride. At the same time, the major constraint for the swappable battery system is, for a residential charging system, we are using only 33 paise per kilometer. But for swappable charging system, this per kilometer running cost will be goes on increases up to 1.5 to 2 rupees. Because the swappable charging system is used by some agencies, some charging infrastructure providers, they must have as extra batteries and infrastructure for using this swappable system. That is for the small systems like this auto rickshaws, bike, etc., etc. For a car is concerned, they are using minimum 10 to 12 kilowatt batteries, which is used by swappable system also can be used. For that one, the charging stations, just like petrol pump or wherever it was placed, from there we can use the swappable battery system. But automatic swappable single battery system. For a 10 kilowatt battery system whose weight will be more than 100 kg, by using the lift or devices, the battery swappable senders can replace the battery and given the battery within 5 minutes time and they can ride. But the cost of charging will be much, much higher than the onboard charging systems or residential charging system. Government will think about this swappable battery system, and all the providers also thinking about the swappable battery system. The major problem for the implementation is the concentration of the e-vehicle in road will be very, very minimum to sustain the cost of swappable battery system. Once the number of vehicle increases in the market, automatically these the different type of system will coming in the picture. These all are the both are one will be supplement to the other. Once the electric cars increases, automatically charging infrastructure goes on increasing. Once charging infrastructure goes on increasing, electric vehicle concentration goes on increasing. So these two things are supplement each other.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank
okay. You, sir. Okay, Professor Shiva.
Yes, sir. Clear, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Any queries from participant side? Then I request some of the participants to give you a feedback regarding this session. Any one of you, please step forward and give your feedback regarding the session.
So may I?
Sure.
Yes, ma'am, yes.
So I am Dipya, working in a clinical engineering as associate professor. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to talk about say the feedback about Shahjahan sir. The talk was very good and informative, sir. We the academicians are very very much lagging about the practical side. Thank you, sir, for giving such a wonderful talk. There was a lot of things to be learned from your talk, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. There is another area you people will be look into the matter is the major area which you can face will be the future mobility is on e-mobility with a hydrogen fuel mobility. The future fuel will be the hydrogen fuel, not for lithium battery or lithium titanate battery.
That is a new battery.
That technology will be entirely different. This is the e-vehicle with the battery technology itself, but whose fuel will be the hydrogen fuel. Hydrogen is the most dangerous fuel because you are sitting above the hydrogen bomb. But there is so many security features are there, securities are there, but you don't worry about the hydrogen bomb. But the thing will be, a small cylinder of hydrogen can have a capability of riding minimum 1,000 kilometers for a vehicle. One feet of cylinder or 1.5 feet of cylinder can able to run an auto rickshaws for 500 to 1,000 kilometers. That is what is called the hydrogen fuel cells. That is what is fuel cells. The technology is quite simple. You know what is hydrogen, then once it is combined with atmospheric air, it will eliminate the water, that is H2O. So once this is an exothermic reaction, this energy, this combination reaction is an exothermic reaction, some chemical engineering guys will know. With that exothermic reaction, what happened? The tremendous amount of energy is eliminating from this combination reaction. That is quite simple, the hydrogen bomb. So this energy can be fed to the fuel cells, and this energy is stored in the small batteries, and which will be ride by using these batteries, this motor will ride. That is quite simple technologies. So this water can be again decomposed to form a hydrogen. Quite simple. This hydrogen can be manufactured from even seawater, so slaughter waste, plastic. Then one of the byproduct of this crude oil manufacturing, the petrol diesel manufacturing, the last byproducts will be methane. This methane can be converted into hydrogen and carbon. This is the process what they are doing in IOCL and other companies. They have the tremendous amount of hydrogen fuel, hydrogen gas is available. This 99.9% of pure hydrogen can be used for hydrogen fuel. Hydrogen fuel technologies. That is the future technology. Some companies are developing the future technologies. Some government also going for formulating the rules regarding this hydrogen fuel. You can also think about the hydrogen fuel cells and the development of hydrogen fuels and other technologies behind that one. Okay.
So what about the cost, then?
Initially the cost will be more, but the people will accept it because there is no constraints regarding this mileage issues here.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
For example, will be initially I launch my vehicle which will be costing approximately same as our IC engine auto rickshaws. For example, 3.85 lakhs per auto rickshaw with a 90 kilometer range. But after that, I got some feedback from the customers. There was more range. I introduced another one will be 120 range, 180 range, and a 230 range. For the 230 range vehicle, costing will be 4.95 lakhs plus tax. But people will accept it. Some people request that vehicle because they are running it around 150 to 180 kilometers or 200 kilometers. The return of investment will be 2 to 2.5 years. So they are happy. Okay.
Okay, sir.
One more query, sir. One of the participants named Jyoti Prakash has asked that what is the amount of energy consumed for charging a 2 kilowatt battery and what are the charging port system? Sir, I will repeat the question. What is the amount of energy consumed for charging a 2 kilowatt battery and what are the charging port system?
Okay, one second. A 6 kilowatt battery took approximately 6 units of current. So a 2 kilowatt battery can took around 2 units of current. Okay. Normally, 2 units of current means per unit of current, the normal residential charge will be 5.5 rupees per unit of time. So for 2 units, it goes up to 11 rupees for this 2 kilowatt batteries. For 2 kilowatt batteries, you can for a two wheeler, it can ride up to 70 to 100 kilometers. So your costing will be 15 paise 20 paise per kilometer. If it is a three wheeler, more power motors, it requires the more. That means normally, as our calculation, we are using 2.2 kilowatt average kilowatt power motor average, and whose maximum power will be 4.5 to 5 kilowatt, whose per kilometer running cost will be approximately 50 paise only. Okay. This is the scenario for this charging and other things, and you can also having some areas you can worked out how to limit the current for these motors. There are two different types of motors available for the e-vehicle nowadays. One will be brushless DC motor, BLDC motor, and the second will be PMSM motor, permanent magnet synchronous motor, whose torque will be much more than the BLDC motor. So this motor will induct normally more than average current. So your people, you and your students will think about how to limit the current. If the vehicle is using only two, for example, my motor is 2 kilowatt motor, average 2.2 kilowatt motor. For normal running, it use only 2 kilowatt power only. For 2 kilowatt power, what will be the current? How we limit the current? For the this economic mode running. For the normal mode running, it took 2500 kilowatt or 3 kilowatt. For that 3 kilowatt, how we can current limit the current? For the power mode, it requires 4500 kilowatt power. For that one, it may go up to the maximum current. For with maximum current, we can go with the power mode. So the thing will be without this current limiting circuits or current limiting conditions, normally once this accelerate, the throttle is going beyond some small level, it will carry a current of maximum power. For example, the maximum power, the current will be 83 ampere, means almost all the conditions. Once will be, it is beyond the 30 kilometers, almost all the conditions will be, it took 83 amperes, because the normal riding pattern of an auto driver is, he is not a technically expert guy. Normally, he is using the different manner for using this accelerators or throttle. The throttle is used by the magnetic insertion like that. So the small changes will happen, will be more current will be induced in the motor. Okay, motor will take more powers. So what happened is, we can use the three different modes of switches. One will be economy mode and a normal mode and power mode. So whatever will be the driving pattern, the current will be limited up to 30 ampere. Then the second stage, it will be limited up to 45 ampere. Only power mode, it will be goes up to more than 80 amperes. So what happened is, the range can be increased. How the range can be increased? 83 ampere can be reduced to the 40 ampere, means that the range can be increased by minimum of 60 to 70%. If it is 100 kilometers, we can go up to 150 to 160 kilometers. So the cost will be reduced, mobility standard will increase, people will accept it. This is one of my suggestion here. You can just think about that one. If you have any solution, you just please call me. Sir, we can do like this. We have prepared this one circuitry for that one. I can test it, no issue. Okay? Okay.
Sir, Jyoti Prakash sir is telling that but lifetime of this permanent magnet is less than electromagnet. So if this happens, within how much frequency we have to change the battery?
Pardon?
Sir, Jyoti Prakash sir is asking, but lifetime of permanent magnet is less than electromagnet. So if this happens, within how much frequency we have to change the battery?
Well, battery change and the permanent magnet condition is something different. These are the two different areas. Battery is some other area. PMSM is a motor condition here. Okay. So yes, sir, PMSM, yes. But actually I don't know exactly regarding the life cycle of the PMSM motor. That I will find out and I will get back to you. As far as the battery is concerned, I already told the lithium ion battery. That is, lithium battery having so many chemistries. Lithium ferrophosphate is one of the chemistry. NMC, nickel manganese cobalt is another chemistry used by the lithium ion batteries. And so many other chemistries are using. With the lithium ferrophosphate and with the lithium ferrophosphate, one second. Sir, I have a meeting. സാർ ഡ്രാഫ്റ്റ് നേരത്തെ റിക്രൂട്ട്മെന്റ് റൂൾസ് അയച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്, പക്ഷെ എല്ലാവരുടെയും കൂടെ ചേർത്തുള്ളത് നമ്മൾ അയച്ചിട്ടില്ല സാർ. എല്ലാവരുടെയും കൂടെ ചേർത്തുള്ള ബോർഡ് അപ്രൂവ് ചെയ്ത് അയച്ചിട്ടില്ല സാർ. അത് പിന്നെ ഓ ശരി 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 ഞാൻ അയച്ചേക്കാം. ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ. സോറി ഫോർ ദ ഇൻകൺവീനിയൻസ്. സോ ദിസ് ഈസ് ലിഥിയം ഫെറോഫോസ്ഫേറ്റ് ആൻഡ് NMCs ആർ ദ ടു മേജർ സിസ്റ്റം യൂസിംഗ്. വിത്ത് ദീസ് ടു സിസ്റ്റംസ് whose life cycle will be 1500 to 2000 life cycle. A life cycle of the battery means a battery can fully charge and fully discharge will take a one life cycle. So we can charge 1500 times fully charge and fully discharge. So per charging it can ride up to 100 kilometers, means 1500 into 100. So 1.5 lakh kilometer range will be the life cycle of the battery, or 2 lakh kilometer range will be the life cycle of the battery. One thing. Second thing, one battery is constructed by using large numbers of lithium cells. Any one of the cells can be damaged, so we can replace that cell only. But the total life of the battery will reduce. That is the battery technologies. Because one cell having the lesser life, we can add the new cell into that particular cell. This new cell will take more work than other cells. There are so many technologies available for this one. What is balancing the cell? Cell balancing technologies are available to balance this each and every cell. And at the same time, BMS is also used for the batteries for balancing the current output for each cell. That is lithium ferrophosphate. In the case of a lithium titanate, the life cycle will be 25,000 life cycle. That means the 7 years of warranty. The other will be the lithium ferrophosphate will be 2 to 3 years warranty. The lithium titanate will be 7 to 10 years warranty. So the life will be more, but the cost will be two times more than the lithium ion battery. So we can use this lithium titanate battery, but whose charging time will be very less. It is less than 20 minutes for full charging and less than 8 minutes for 80% charging. This is simple regarding the battery technologies. But PMSM is the different areas that is not related to the battery life. Okay?
Okay, sir. Sir, recently I got a real-time experience. In fact, I got an opportunity to get a ride in an electric auto. Which is produced by Kerala Auto Mobiles Limited.
Very good.
And the auto driver was complaining to me that, like, I was asking him, what is the experience you are having when you have shifted from the diesel engine one or petrol engine one to this electric auto? He said that the vehicle is very smooth, it does not have any vibration. Even I too felt the same. But he made a complaint that people are not ready to take rides in the auto rickshaw, considering that this is something entirely different from the normal auto, and the charges, everything, fares, all for this will be entirely different. So this is a completely non-technical scenario, And how you people are handling this situation, sir? Because the color of the auto is entirely different. It is having a white with a blue color, blue shade. Comparing with the traditional or conventional black and yellow color auto rickshaw. So definitely the customers or the people who are taking the ride in the usual autos are hesitant to take this one.
It is from Talasseri or Kannur?
No, sir. This experience I had it from Trivandrum. This ride was in Trivandrum, sir, in Medical College Trivandrum.
Okay. In Trivandrum, it's around so many ladies auto drivers riding our vehicle. They are using our vehicle, but they are so much happy regarding the vehicle. The thing will be when they are using the diesel autos, their daily take-home amount will be only 400 to 500 rupees. Once it is shifted to the electrical, their take-home will be more than 900 to 1000. That is so much happy with these auto drivers. The second will be, this is the first information coming out from any person regarding that one. The people will hesitate to ride through these auto rickshaws. Yeah. Maybe this is correct. The better thing will be, this is not for the fear about traveling this auto or fear about the charging and other thing, but they feel that this color will be something different, white and blue. So they feel that this is not a public auto rickshaw. This may be a private auto rickshaw. It is used by some private people. So it is not for the riding purpose like that they will feel. Maybe that is the reason. But that can be eliminated by the presence of vehicle will be more in the market. It can automatically will eliminate. That is the only way we have to do. Or we can do some demonstration, or we can do some free ride at every auto stand regularly. Maybe this some part will be eliminated, and only social media can be eliminated. Not nowadays the techniques are using social media very little than the uneducated, unemployed, poor people can use the this social media much better than ourselves. So we use the social media to correct these issues. I can take this issue and I will address these issues. Definitely I will address that issues and I will give some steps to eliminate these issues. Okay, sir. Anything else?
Okay, sir. Thank you, Shah Jahan, sir, for spending your valuable time with us. You have carved the presentation in accordance with the title of this FDP. You have very clearly explained us the real-time challenges, solutions for it, and the various government policies. On behalf of participants and College of Engineering Talasseri, I express my wholehearted thanks to you for being with us for a wonderful session. Thank you, sir.
Okay, then the connection was over. Okay. Hello.
Sir, thank you, Shah Jahan, sir, for spending your valuable time for us. You have carved your presentation in accordance with the title of this FDP. You have clearly explained us the real-time challenges, solutions for it, and the various government policies. On behalf of participants and College of Engineering Talasseri, I express my wholehearted thanks to you for being with us for such a wonderful session. Thank you, sir.
Thank you all.
And all the participants are also commenting in the chat session that it was such a wonderful session, a good informative session. Thank you. Thanks a lot for a wonderful session, sir.
Okay. Thank you all. Thank you. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Bye.
Yes, participants, our next session will begin at 11:15. Hope all of you have got the attendance link. Please fill the attendance link. It's not an automated one. You have to fill it, then only your attendance will be ended. So I request all participants to take a short break and resume by 11:15.
Professor, one kind request.
Yes, sir, please.
You just send on acknowledgement so that it will be easy for us to track whether our attendance is accepted or not.
Yes, sir, it's accepted. Yeah, it's actually
just enable that option.
Okay, fine, sir. Fine. Definitely, I will do that.
Thank you.
Excuse me, sir. I have a question.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes. The thing is that due to some bad network, there is sometimes we get disconnected. So I request please share the link two or three times so that if somebody
yes. Definitely, sir. Definitely. Okay. In a single day, I will share the link of attendance link of all the sessions several times, so nobody will miss out the attendance.
Okay. See. Thank you.
Yes. So hope to see you all soon.
Excuse me, sir.
11:15. Yes, Praveen.
Sir, will you share the recorded video sessions in
the recorded video sessions will be shared in the YouTube channel. It's accordance with the YouTube policy. AICT policy. AICT has clearly given us instructions to share all the video sessions in a YouTube channel. We will share we will share it in our YouTube channel of college, and we will share you the link.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So
okay,
much.
See you soon at 11:15.
Yes, sir. There are only two points on which we have to give feedback, no? Like name selection and
Feedback has to be given. Feedback, that is the final feedback
and written
attendance. You have to give it in the Google Forms. Feedback, you have to give it in the Adal portal, sir. That is only after the session
completion
has.
Of this
yeah, only sessions. After the completion of the sessions, all the 5-day sessions.
Yeah, fine. Thank
okay,
you.
Sir. Okay, sir. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Yeah.